Hey everyone, what is up? Welcome back to another video. So today we are talking about one of my favorite things, one of my favorite style of photos which I like to watch on Instagram. That is, how do you make a single photo turn into two different photos when you slide them? You may have seen photos that look something like this, wherein there is a single photo but we have to slide it and we think that they are two photos, but no, it's a single photo. There's no separation of those two photos and it looks completely great. One of the things with such kind of photos are that they are very phenomenal. Secondly, the algorithm supports such photos a lot. What I mean by algorithm is that you may have seen on Instagram sometimes when somebody uploads multiple photos, then if the same photo, the same feed comes to your post once again, you won't see the exactly same photo, you will see the different photo in that same particular feed, and that what makes the algorithm change the photo, because it already knows that you have seen that photo and that same photo is not what you want to see. So if somebody uploads multiple photos in that particular manner, and when you later discover that yeah, that photo is though a multiple uploaded photo but it's the same file because it does not have a partition in between or does not have a separation which distinguishes this one particular photo with the another, and that's where you get the fascination of how to do it. Especially that's what I was thinking about, of how to do it, and now I have figured a way out which I'm gonna teach you today. Now, full disclaimer, I'm using Adobe Photoshop. You can use any other editing app, photo editing app. It can also be done on mobile platforms. So this pyramid which I have, I photographed it this morning, and this particular photo is what is the result of what I clicked. Now this is the photo which I have clicked right there, and I want this photo to go on Instagram, but the thing is that this is a 3x2 size of photo which I want to make a 4x size photo for maximum room in your device. What are we going to do is we are going to open this file in Photoshop, and you need to do a couple of things which will help you get same sort of output for any different kind of photos which you are going for. So what you need to do is, first of all, crop this photo into 16:10 ratio. So now what does that mean? Because you want the photos to be 4x5 and you also don't want your photos to get cropped out, you can do the same by having two photos of 4x5 of that single photo. So what I am going to do is, I am going to select the crop tool and then I am going to crop it for a ratio of 1280 pixels by 800 pixels, and that is 16:10. So if I do the crop, I get this particular image. Now what I want to do is, I want these photos to be two different photos which will go on Instagram, but it will not be partitioned by any manner, so it does not look weird. So what I will do is, I'll go and hold the crop tool until I see the slice tool option, and then I'll select it. Now what I need to do is just make a selection over this photo, and I will do it till the time I see a pink line which indicates the center of that photo. If you do not see the pink line at the first part where you make the selection, you can anyways drag that yellow line which is formed until the pink line comes up again. That indicates what the center of the photo is, where the center of the photo is. Now the key thing to note is that what you need to do is, when you're making a selection, you need to be through the photo that the vertical section of the photo gets covered completely. So I make a selection out of the photo so that the complete vertical and the horizontal section of the photo gets selected. Now if you don't want this particular middle part of your photo, or if you want to have any other vertical section of the photo from where you want your partition to be, so you can simply select Control apostrophe or Command apostrophe on a Mac to bring up the grids, with the help of which you can make these selections as per your choice. But since I want the selection to be in the middle of this photo, I will drag it to the center. So now this is the main part which you have to do. Now the thing is, when you will be exporting this photo, you go to File, you go to Export. Now you have to select Save for Web Legacy. Now you can see that here we have the photo in JPEG format, and coming to the image size, I want this to be 1350. because that is the maximum height which Instagram will provide. If it goes above this, then welcome compression. So that's what we don't want in our photos to happen. So now you do this for the first part, and now you come here in this section, you select the minus button, and you can see two different photos are available. Now this is the first photo which was selected, and the settings which we did right now was the first photo to which the settings were applied. Now you can do this for the second photo as well. However, Photoshop will preferably do that for you, so you don't need to do it again. But for a check, you can go and check that if it is 1350 and your file type is JPEG, and then you come to quality and select it to 100%. Then you can select save. Now the location where you will be saving your photos, it will have two different photos in a folder. So if I select a new folder here, say photos, and I'll open it up, and now this is here I will be saving my images. So I have selected save, and now I can go into the folder created photos, in which I have these two images with me. So now these are the two photos which will go on Instagram. Now when you are selecting your photos on Instagram, you want to select multiple files, but when you select one photo, you make sure to click the square icon to expand the size of your photos, because that's where you don't want your photos to get compressed again by Instagram. And then you upload the photos in multiple formats, because once you select the compression factor wherein your photos might be 4:5 or 1:1 ratio, after that when you select multiple files, Instagram would not offer that same option. So you need to do that first. After that you can do select your photos and then upload it in a manner which is shown here. And that is how it looks like to make multiple photos from a single photo and upload it, so that users can slide the photo and enjoy what they get. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, make sure to press the like button, subscribe to the channel, click the bell icon, do that stuff, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Next video is going to be